Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about how we can analyze this posture in a frontal view. Or it basically that means we are analyzing the patient or the subject in a frontal view. That means we are looking from the front or from the back of the subject. So in anterior view, the line of gravity bisects the body into two symmetrical halves. If you want to say that in frontal view, the posture is in normal or in equilibrium. The both the half or the both the side of the body should be in a symmetrical position. That means if you cut the body into two equal halves, that means right and left, both the right should be symmetrical with the left side, and the head should be in a straight position. There should not be any tilting or any rotation. That means the head should be positioned in a straight line in relation with the thorax, and it should not have any kind of side tilting or any rotatory movements. And the line of gravity bisect the face into two equal halves. That means if we divide the face, if the line of gravity divide the face into two, both the sides should have a normal symmetry. The eyes, clavicle and the shoulder should be in the same level. That means both the eyes should be on a same level, both the clavicle should be on a same level, and both the shoulders also should be on a same level, and all this line should be parallel to the ground where you are standing. That means there should not be any tilting with the eyes on the clavicle or with the shoulder in posterior. That means these are all the things which we are looking in an anterior view. So if you are assessing the patient by standing in front of the patient, what we are looking, we should be looking for both the eye should be in a straight line, and the clavicle, both the clavicle should be on a straight line, and both the shoulders also should be on a straight line. And then if you are looking at the patient from the posterior view, the inferior angles of both scapulae should be parallel to equidistance from the line of gravity. So this is the posterior view. That means we are seeing the patient from posterior. So this is the inferior angle of clavicle. So we got two clavicles, two scapula, and these are the inferior angle of scapula. And these two inferior angles of scapula should be on an equal distance from the line of gravity. So basically we can say that the line of gravity passing through the spinous process of spinal cord. So this is the line of gravity, and if you see that both the clavicles inferior angle are positioned in equal distance from this line of gravity. So that's what we are looking in posterior view. And next is the waist angles and the gluteal folds should be equal. That means the distance from the line of gravity to the gluteal folds or two gluteal folds, that means the right and left gluteal folds should be symmetrical with each side. The ASIs and PSIs should lie on a same line which is parallel to the ground, as well as being equidistant from the line of gravity. So this is the anterior superior. So this is the anterior superior iliac spine, and this is the line of gravity which is passing central. The distance from this ASIs to the distance from right ASIs to this line of gravity should be equal to the line distance from the line of gravity and the left ASIs. That means both the side should be equally distant from the line of gravity. The joint axis of hip, knee and ankle are equidistant from the line of gravity, and the gravitational line transects the central portion of vertebral bodies. So that's what we said. Both the joints, both the hip, knee and ankle joint should be equally distanced from the line of gravity. And the line of, in anterior view, the line of gravity is actually passing through the body of vertebral column. So these are the things which we are looking when we are observing anterior view. That means the both eyes should be on the same level. Bilateral symmetry of head and facial bones and the earlobes. Both the earlobes should be at the same level and should be parallel to the ground. The line of gravity should bisect the cervical vertebral bodies. Both the shoulder should be at the same level. And it is actually bisecting the sternum. And the next one is nipple level. Both the nipples are in the same, should be on the same level. And the arm to thoracic distance. And there should be a symmetrical arm to thoracic distance in right and left side. And the line of gravity then it goes down by bisecting the vertebral bodies. And it should be bisecting the umbilicals and the pelvic thrust level. That means both the ASIS should be equally distanced from the line of gravity. And both the ASIS should be on a same line. And both the greater trochanter should be on a straight level. And this line of gravity passes down by bisecting the pubic symphysis. This is the pubic symphysis and it is passing down through this pubic symphysis. Then both the hip joint. Both the hip joint should be equidistant from the line of gravity. Both the knee joint also equidistant from the line of gravity. And both the malleolus are in the same line. And it should be equidistant from the line of gravity. So this is the anterior view. That means how we are analyzing the subject from anterior view. So basically, both the eyes should be on the same level. This means both the eyes should be on the same level. Ears should be on the same level. The clavicle should be on the same level, shoulders on same level, nipples on same level, and both the ASIS. So these are the ASIS. So both the ASIS should be on same level. Both greater trochanter should be on same level, and knees should be equally distanced from the line of gravity. And both the malleolus are in the same line and equidistant from the line of gravity. So those are the things which we are looking from anterior view. Next is posterior view. What are the things which we need to look in posterior view? Bilateral symmetry of head. That means the right and left side of head should be on a symmetrical line. And next is in posterior view, the line of gravity passing through the cervical spinous process. And both the shoulder should be on same level. Both the acromion should be on same level. And the scapula should be positioned normally. That means the scapula should not be tilted anteriorly or posteriorly. It should be normally positioned. And the inferior angle of scapula should be at the same level and should have an equidistant from the line of gravity. And then it passes through the thoracic spinous process. And both the trunk of left and right side, that means the bilateral trunk, should be on a symmetrical position. And then the line of gravity passes through the lumbar spinal process. Then the pelvic crest level, that means both the PSIS should be at the same level and should have an equidistance from this line of gravity. Then greater trochanter, both the greater trochanter at the same level. Next is gluteal folds. Both the gluteal cleft are the same level or should be at the same level. And the knee joint are in the same level or the same level and should have an equidistance from the line of gravity. And both the malleolus should be on same level. So this is how we can analyze a proper posture in an anterior or in a posterior view. That means in the frontal view, this is how we can, these are the landmarks which we need to looking for analyzing the posture. So this is how we need to examine the subject. The head. In the head, the line of gravity passes through the middle of the forehead, nose and chin. And what we need to observe? The observation should be the eyes and ears should be at the same level and should be symmetrical. Next is neck and shoulder. When you correlate with the line of gravity, the neck and shoulder, in the neck, the line of gravity passes through the body of cervical vertebrae. And if you look in the shoulder, both the shoulders should be equally distanced from the line of gravity. And what we need to observe, right and left angles between shoulder and neck should be symmetrical. And clavicles also should be on a same level and it should be symmetrical. And in chest, the line of gravity passes through the middle of xiphoid process. And the observation should be ribs on each side should be symmetrical. Next is abdomen or hips passes to the umbilicus. The line of gravity passes to the umbilicus. And the observation, the right and left waist angles should be symmetrical. Next is hips or pelvis. The line of gravity passes on a line equidistant from the right and left anterior superior iliac spine and passes to the pubic symphysis. And observation, anterior superior iliac spine should be at the same level. Next is knee joint. The line of gravity passes in between the knee joints and both the knee joints are in an equidistant from the line of gravity. And the observation should be the patella should be symmetrical and facing straight ahead. That means the patella should be positioned in the patella fossa in a proper manner. Next is angle of feet. The line of gravity passes between the ankles equidistant from the medial malleoli. The malleoli should be symmetrical and feet should be parallel. Toes should not be curled, overlapping or deviated to one side. So these are the basic parameters or observation which we are observing when we are analyzing a anterior posture. Next we are going to looking for what are the deviations which we can find in the frontal view. So basically in foot and toes we can find out the pes planus and pes cavus, whether there is increase in the normal arch or whether there is a decrease in normal arch in relation with the position of calcaneum. So this is what we can observe in a pes planus foot. That means the calcaneum. So this is the calcaneum. So this calcaneum is tilted to one side. That means the calcaneum is tilted to lateral side. So this is what we can observe in a posterior view or in a posterior analysis of posture. We can identify that the calcaneum is laterally tilted. So that can result in a diminished arch. So or a pes planus. So when we observe the foot from posterior, what are the findings which you can found? First one is the calcaneum is tilted to lateral, and next is the navicular bone is dropped. So these are the indications of pes planus. So this can be identified in a posterior view. Or if there is an excess in arch height or the pes cavus, that means in those cases the calcaneum will be medially tilted and the navicular will be positioned much higher than normal. So those are the findings in pes cavus. And in knee joint, genu valgum or genu varium, that means both nocni and bolec, can be identified using posterior or anterior analysis. Squinting or crossed eyes patella. So this is the genu valgum and next one is genu varium. So these two knee joint conditions can be identified using anterior or posterior analysis. Next is squinting or crossed eye patella. That means the patella are positioned abnormally in the patella fossa. So those are the two conditions which we can find. One is squinting of patella or grasshopper's eye. So in squinting of patella, what happens? Both the patellas are placed medial in the patellar fossa. And in grasshopper's eye, both the patellas are placed lateral to the patellar fossa. So these are the two abnormalities which we can identify in anterior or anterior post analysis in knee joint. The squinting or crossed eyed patella, that means the patella is facing medially on patella fossa. Next is grasshopper's eye patella, refers to a high laterally displaced position of the patella in which the patella faces upward and outward. Next is vertebral column. The scoliosis is an abnormal curving or abnormal lateral curvature in the spinal column. In normal condition, the spine got only anterior or posterior curvature that we can found in normal vertebra. In cervical, we have a lordosis. In thoracic region, we have kyphosis. And also in lumbar region, we have lordosis. So those are the normal curvatures which we can find in the vertebral column. But there are something called as abnormal vertebral curvatures or abnormal lateral curvatures. So those are the things which are called as scoliosis. Scoliosis is consistent lateral deviation of a series of vertebra from the line of gravity in one or more regions of the spine may indicate the presence of lateral spinal curvature in the frontal plane, which is called as a scoliosis. There are two classifications of curve, functional curve and structural curve. Functional curve means it is an adaptational thing. That means because of some muscular imbalance or because of some abnormal positioning or abnormal postural activities, this may result in functional scoliosis. But in case of structural curves are mainly because of deformities to the bones or deformities to the vertebral bodies. So the functional curves are called non-structural curve in that they can be reversed if the course of curve is corrected. These curves are the result of correctable imbalance such as a leg length discrepancy or a muscle spasm. So that functional means due to some functional adaptations which have happened in the spinal column, either by muscular activities or by any other functional reasons, this curve can be occurred. So those are the things which we call as a functional curve, and the functional curve can be reversed by correcting those abnormalities. If it is a muscular imbalance, if you can train that particular group of muscles which are lacking of strength or endurance, if you train those muscles, these functional curves can be corrected. And next is structural curves. As the name suggests, it involves some changes in the body structures, either in vertebral columns or the intervertebral disc. All the surrounding structures are going for some pathological changes or some abnormalities, so that can result in structural curves. So this is the scoliosis. Scoliosis means lateral curvature or spine. So in this we can find out that whole body's normal posture system is altered only because of this scoliosis. So this scoliosis can result in abnormal shoulder positions, tilting of head, abnormal PSI's position, and the scapulas are not equidistant from the line of gravity. And in case this line of gravity is exactly altered in this posture, in normal posture, how this line of gravity is passing? The line of gravity should pass through the middle of this vertebral bodies. But in case of this lateral curvature, it is not actually passing middle through the vertebral bodies.